You know, the Congo War has, like, more people have died in, like, the Congo War, the Congo conflicts, than, like, World War II and World War I combined or some crazy shit.
That sounds about right.
What? Yeah.
It's been going on for, like, 20
years. Yeah,
it's
just been, like, 30, 40 years of
fucking,
like,
just nonstop machete. Civil war.
All right, so we got, all right, so this is all them.
Yeah. Captagon. That's what I was talking about. Captagon's the new drug that Syria's pushing to the whole world. It's a strong amphetamine.
So we got 1997 to present, Islamic terrorism in Egypt. That's not really Islamic insurgency in Maghreb. Operation Enduring Freedom, Horn of Africa. That's us. Operation Enduring Freedom, Trans-Sahara. Islamist civil war in Somalia. ISIL insurgency in Tunisia. Islamist insurgency in Mozambique. War in Darfur. Conflict in Niger Delta. Kivu conflict. Sudanese nomadic conflicts. The ethnic violence in South Sudan. We have the Mali War. There's just a shit ton. Central African Republic Civil War. Batwa Luba clashes. Some of these are just like 14 people get killed, I think. But like, the Tigray War. Well, the thing is, but the difference, Middle East has like oil, but Africa, I feel like since we're becoming less oil dependent and we're becoming more dependent on precious minerals, it's going to switch over to Africa.
Mm.
And, which also has oil. The thing is you have like, I don't know. I just think that's what's going to happen next.
And going into Africa, that's so old world.
Yeah,
that's
so weird.
I kind of like it.
It's kind of romantic, right? You hear like the Indiana Jones theme in the background. but you see like...
I mean, this is like stuff on Reddit. Is USA as bad as it sound on Reddit?
Yeah.
20,000 upvotes.
It's bad in like a different way. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's like.
Like, it's like nobody. It's like a dystopian bad. I really want to like.
You can't get like, you know, insulin, but you can fucking get the largest drink you've ever had in your life.
Yeah.
Like,
New Orleans rocks.
The U.S. is bad as far as, healthcare system. We were just, before it shut off or whatever, the homeless problem, things like that. But our country is so much better than everyone else's country.
We have the best art. For sure, but that's kind of dwindling at the moment.
Best restaurants.
Who beats us?
They don't, but I'm just saying, like, we're not, it's not as cool anymore. Like, it's, you know.
It's not as good. There's just nothing good being made anywhere. You know who's going to kill us is Korea. They just bought, like, Endeavor Entertainment.
They're kicking ass. I mean, Parasite was, like, a very American-feeling movie, just in Korean. I didn't like Minari that much.
What the fuck's Minari?
I didn't see Minari.
It's a movie about these Koreans.
And Snowpiercer wasn't that great either.
I like Snowpiercer.
It was all right. It wasn't terrible, but, you know.
I like that Chris Evans fella.
Okay.
How come everyone hates Chris Pratt? He's always in the news.
I think he's great.
It's just they all hate him because he like likes God. He's like,
that's the thing. He's like a Republican that likes
Chris
cops
Pratt
and God.
Will just be like, I like my wife. I love my wife and I love my kids and I go to church and everyone on Twitter's like, you fucking piece of shit.
It's insane.
It's kind insane. Of hilarious.
It's like these. It's because he's not a member of the active death cult.
Sure, I'm sure he's said Twitter. Something based in his religion on
who gives a
gay marriage maybe something.
I doubt he said anything negative about gays. I guarantee you he has.
I'm gonna type in why does everyone hate Pratt? I was in a fucking elevator.
He's hot.
With Pratt.
He seems nice. Was he kind to you?
He was very kind. He laughed at a joke. I pretended I'd seen his movies. I was like, hey man, I really love everything you're in. I don't think I've ever seen anything he's in, but
yeah.
Why does everyone hate
Devin's
Chris?
Extremely charming to celebrities except Freddie Gibbs.
Freddie liked me and he talked to me, okay? More than you'll ever get.
I will have a 20-minute conversation with Freddie Gibbs one day.
Everyone hates Chris Pratt and not for those awful Guardians of the Galaxy movies.
First of all, the Guardians of the Galaxy movies are good.
I thought the first one was fucking good.
All of them are pretty fucking good.
Okay, moving on. Everyone hates Chris Pratt now, and it's weird. I have the same question I did when I realized that everyone suddenly hated Fall Out Boy and Nickelback. Well, what are you, retarded? You realized everyone hated Fall Out Boy and Nickelback?
Let me count the reasons why Pratt is the worst Chris.
The hate for Chris Pratt appeared in earnest when a user posed the question asking who was the best Hollywood Chris. The options were Pine, Hemsworth, Evans, and Pratt. As Twitter users fired off their preferences, a vocal minority labeled Chris Pratt as the worst Chris. Most chose either Evans or Hemsworth as their favorite. Here are a few of the reasons for Pratt's categorization. In 2011, he rehomed his 19-year-old cat because of incontinence issues. His cat was the one that played Snowbell in the Stuart Little movie. In 2016, his then-wife Anna Faris received a $5,000 fine because authorities found her adopted Chihuahua starving in the street after she rehomed it. What?
That's not her fault. She rehomed it.
And then they fucked up. It's not her fault fucking she sold
also,
it.
Also, who gives a shit?
Yeah, who fucking cares? It was 19 years old. I would have snapped its neck and moved on.
You do that thing. You know how they kill chickens? You swing it around.
Because of this, the internet believes he abuses animals.
Yeah, Pratt's a big animal abuser. He's just like Mike Vick, dude. He's like raping them. Yeah, dude,
he's nuts.
Yeah, he's nuts, dude. He's cutting them in half.
Oh, he's also bad because he follows conservatives on Twitter.
So he's a
conservative white supremacist.
Yep, he's a white supremacist.
He follows Ben Shapiro, Tucker Carlson, Dan Crenshaw, Meghan McCain, and the LAPD.
Yeah, the guys who protect him whenever he's here.
Dude, pretty soon it's going to get to the point where they're like, I heard he paid his water bill. That piece of shit. Did you pay the DWP, you fucking white supremacist?
Where is it? What is it?
It's worth noting that the total number of left-leaning accounts he follows far outweighs the number of right-wing ones. Yeah, well, he's in Hollywood.
He wore
of
a Don't Tread on Me shirt, so he's racist and pro. First of all, that's nothing to do with racism.
He wore a Don't Tread on Me shirt.
That rocks. Yeah. That's sick. He likes guns. The guy's cool. He's a Chad.
He likes just pro-military.
Guns pro-military.
No, it's not pro. It's just, he likes the guns.
He likes snakes.
It means nothing except that he wants
He loves
to
a good
have
snake.
Guns.
He loves he snakes and the flag.
Guns are good. Guns protect us.
He didn't fundraise for Biden, so he's pro-Trump. Right.
He didn't fundraise for Biden, so he's... What?
He goes to an anti-LGBT church, so he's homophobic. Elliot Page called out Chris Pratt in 2019 for being a member of an anti-LGBT church.
For a second.
Aren't they all anti-LGBT
church? Whenever I hear Elliot, I think Elliot, the shooter.
Oh, yeah, Elliot Rogers.
Yeah, I was like, wait, Elliot Rogers called out Chris Pratt?
I'm like, didn't Elliot Page shoot up a fraternity or a sorority?
So he has done anti-gay.
These are all stretches.
You know he's surrounded by gay people daily. There's no way that
he's
guy
in
isn't
Hollywood.
Surrounded by gay people
he's
daily.
He's gay. You have to suck off a few eggs to get to the top in that business.
Suck off a few
eggs. Break a few eggs. That's the Hollywood term. You got to suck off a few eggs to get where you want.
To make an omelet.
Yeah. You want to fuck a green thing in Guardians of the Galaxy? You have to suck my cock.
That's how that Disney meeting went.
And that looks about it. Oh guys, for real. He's on Instagram. He loves his wife. She's looking at him like she loves him.
He's just a simple guy.
That's bad. Well, in this world, no one like has real relationships. Like everyone's like not really in love with who they're with.
I guarantee you he owns like a ranch in Wyoming, and I guarantee you if we spent a weekend there, we'd have a blast.
We'd love him.
We'd love it. We'd
just occasionally he'd occasionally say frick, and you'd be like, just say fuck.
He's saying frick,
Christ's sake.
He's like, fucking dog.
And you go, and then you go like, for Christ's sakes, he goes, hey brother. And you're like, all right, I forgot, but he's your guy.
What if we get there and he really is like?
What if he's nuts? He's what if we get there and he has black people doing a zigzag formation in a field and he's just firing guns at them?
Yeah, he's like fucking a golden retriever, bashing into head.
He's stepping on a golden retriever.
Anna Faris is there, like, taking scissors to a chihuahua's stomach. He's just, like, hating gays.
Anna Faris is, like, his Joseph Mengele.
He's, like, forcing gays to, like, go through, like, saw-like contraptions in his fucking basement. Like, oh, man. We were wrong. Pratt's a monster.
He releases the door to a cage and all these naked minorities run out. He fires an arrow into the sky. He's hunting them and he makes them run around in circles.
He's hunting them with a compound bow with explosive tips on the arrows. He's just blowing up in a field. He's got his Don't Tread on Me.
He keeps talking about how he's gonna be the one that really cuts off Elliot Page's dick.
He's got it in a jar. He's on his mantle. God.
Yeah.
These all sound like the reasons to hate someone when you've built your entire personality on being a Twitter intellectual.
The guy seems like a simple, nice dude.
Right.
He seems like a
exactly.
kind guy. I guarantee if any of these people who are hating on Chris Pratt met him, he'd be absolutely
Wasn't he like
him.
Hilarious in that
he's
show?
He's an extremely talented
community
dude.
Or whatever. Wasn't
it was
he?
Not it was people Parks and Rec. He was the best thing about
Parks and Rec. People love him in that?
Right.
He was like amazing, right?
He was the best thing about Parks and Rec, and then he got jacked and became an A-list celebrity, and it fucking, like, good for him.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Robert Downey Jr., all these people had to come out and defend him. Interesting. Retarded. Everybody's so stupid.
He's just the type of guy that, you know, might post a picture of his plate he got at brunch or something.
Yeah, take and he's
a,
always
take a picture with his wife in front of a water.
If he wasn't an A-list celebrity,
yeah, exactly,
he'd be boring. A firefighter and he'd be at like a Longhorn Steakhouse right now having like lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably enjoys Outback.
Probably. Yeah. We enjoy Outback.
Who doesn't?
What? Yeah.
He's
blooming onions seem to get smaller.
Everything's gotten smaller, yeah. John.
Including my dick.
Damn right. I set you up for that
set
one.
Set me up for that one. Devin teed up the cock joke. Who else does Hollywood hate? Let's see. Not pedophiles and not anyone who actually deserves
to be
hated.
Yeah, what are
hated.
Like
top
most
hated,
celebrities? People in Hollywood?
All right, let's see. Who's this?
Here are some of Hollywood's most hated celebrities. Ooh, juicy. Donald Trump.
Oh,
okay.
There we go.
Shut up.
Kevin Spacey.
Danny Mathers. What who's that? Playboy Playmate? But showed off an ugly heart when she Snapchatted a woman in her 70s changing in an LA.
That's not a celebrity.
LA fitness locker room.
Oh, yeah. That's funny. I sort of remember.
She could face up to 6 months in jail for being mean spirited.
Does it say that mean spirited? It
says she could face up to 6 months in jail for her mean spirited behavior.
You know who wouldn't Snapchat a 7-year-old woman in an LA fitness locker room?
Chris Pratt.
Chris Pratt wouldn't do that.
Damn right.
He'd probably help her out. He'd open a door for her.
He'd be like,
ma'am, do you need help in your car?
Good day,
you want me to lift these groceries for you? They're heavy. Yeah, I'll put my jacket over a puddle.
Yeah. He would.
Anyway, praise God.
I mean, Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby, obvious. Charlie Sheen. Charlie,
he has AIDS.
Let Charlie Sheen go.
Chris Brown.
Chris Brown's the craziest one.
Chris Brown
guy.
And he's not that hated. He's like, he's at award shows.
Women love him still. They don't give a shit.
He's around.
He's had like 30 Ray Rice moments, and like nobody cares.
Chris Brown should be like choked to death.
Yeah, he's a bad guy.
He's a bad guy.
Bad fella. Bad fella.
Jaden Smith is hated?
Why?
It's hard to believe anyone would hate Jaden Smith, especially because he's still in his teens. However, all he received was backlash when he tweeted out, "If everybody in the world dropped out of school, we would have a much more intelligent society."
He's right.
He probably is. Gwyneth Paltrow, she stinks. Yeah. She's like always making
goop.
Yeah, she makes like fucking face cream out of her like pussy juice or something. I don't know what she does.
I'd love to use her face.
What does she do? She like makes candles out of like her
they smell like her
cum or something.
Yeah. They smell like her vagina.
That's interesting.
Erykah Badu also made a perfume that smells like her pussy.
Hulk Hogan.
I kind of like to get that.
He said the N-word.
Oh, yeah. Hulk Hogan's like the reason Gawker got brought down. And
Hulk Hogan sucks.
He like changed the whole like way journalism.
People hate Jason Biggs, the American
Who's
Pie
Jason
guy.
Biggs?
The American
what
Pie
do you,
guy.
Do you read his thing.
Back in 2014, when a Malaysian Airlines plane was shot down in the Ukraine, Jason Biggs made a very bad public joke tweeting, "Anyone want to buy my Malaysian Airlines frequent flyer miles?" How is that bad? Like that's
hilarious.
That's hilarious.
Honestly, he probably wrote that tweet, then sat down, and they took that picture.
Dude, he kicks ass.
He dropped his phone.
Jason Biggs kicks ass. It was a serious case of too soon. Profuse public apologies and deleting the tweet helped a little, but a tasteless joke like that is hard to forget.
Shut up.
Right.
Shut up.
Shut the fuck up. You like the guy because he fucked a pie in 2002, you idiots.
Keep going. Let's see what's up.
Leanne Rimes.
What did Leanne Rimes do? Aside from being called a cheating homewrecker when she linked up with Freddie Cibrian, well, the two were still married. Leanne was also labeled insensitive and selfish when she tweeted, "Not a fun day. I have a stomach bug. Oh, joy. And one of our best friends is losing his mom." What? I don't know what that means. Blake Shelton. What'd he do? Blake Shelton has a big personality and a big heart, but sometimes he doesn't think before he tweets. Back in 2011, he wrote Shania Twain lyrics that read, "Any man that tries touching my behind will end up beaten and bleeding."
This whole article is just people who had a poor tweet.
Yeah, they wrote one bad tweet. Gilbert Gottfried.
Don't start. He's the nicest,
kind
man.
Fuck Roland Martin, former CNN commentator, allegedly lost his job and has a tarnished reputation for unapology sending out blatant homophobic tweets.
Yeah, I mean, look at him.
Yeah, look at that guy.
Jesus Christ. He's like,
he's gay. That's why he hates himself.
So look up the person who wrote that article. Let's find out what they're about.
It was from Hollywood.com.
But there's going to be an author.
There's more.
Okay, let's look another one. Let's keep going.
Here's 20. The 20 most hated celebrities. Why we hate them.
Donald Trump at the top of the list?
Again, Donald Trump's at the top of the list?
No, it's... Kristen Stewart, number two. She slouches and doesn't wash her hair.
So?
That's not a reason to hate somebody.
Sounds like
you're
jealous of how hot she is.
Lindsay Lohan, number 16, sleeps through court dates and doesn't brush her teeth.
Yeah, she's
that sounds
awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah, I love Lindsay.
That's cool.
She's trash. I love trash.
That fucking rocks.
Lindsay Lohan may be wasting her talent, not trying hard enough. This is a terrible list because it's like not out of order.
Okay,
it goes number one, Gwyneth Paltrow, Kristen Stewart, Jennifer Lopez. I hear Jennifer Lopez, huge cunt.
Yeah.
Doesn't let people look at her and
super
shit.
Hot. John Mayer. I heard he likes to poop on people.
John Mayer?
Yeah, he likes to take shits on people. Like, he's tired of regular sex or something, and he just shit. Like, there was a Reddit article, somebody slept with John Mayer.
Doesn't he say weird shit about, like, didn't he say some weird shit about, like, black women a while back?
Maybe. I don't know.
He's like, all women are black when they're smeared with shit.
That's good though. You want your rock stars to get tired of sex.
Yeah.
You know, I fucked so much that
you know all. What I want is this top 20 list and see how many of them are like pedophiles or something.
They're not. It's like, you know, Matt Lauer, Madonna. It's all the same. It's like, well, it's Anne. I didn't know Anne Hathaway was hated.
She seems annoying, but also I guarantee if we had
lunch. She did something. I can't remember.
These people.
She tweeted something. Everyone just tweeted something.
Yeah, it's all a tweet.
Everyone. That's all it is.
Tweets or rape. That's the only thing that can get you in this biz.
Never tweet.
The rape's a 50-50. It could make you famous.
Yeah, rape,
it could make you
go far with.
Have you seen it all with Judge Joe Brown? Is up to these days?
No.
He has some like podcast and he's an absolute insane man. I've just seen clips of it here and there, like when something What's maybe gets saying? Posted on like
he
World
like goes
Star.
Nuts.
Just like, yeah, look up Judge Joe Brown. He was he essentially said that he was like, George Floyd died crying like a baby.
Oh,
to his
I saw
mom.
That. Damn. I saw that.
He's absolutely insane. I had no idea that Judge Joe Brown was such a it seems like almost like a self-hating black man.
Yeah. George Floyd. Who was George Floyd?
Porn star George
I've
Floyd.
Heard about this guy for years.
Yeah, that first one, I think.
It's like 7 minutes long.
I have a crush.
Oh, God.
Oh, shut up.
You guys don't know about...
Shut up, whores!
Just get a YouTube premium account.
We need it for the pod.
Do not come on here promoting... another YouTuber. I don't know that DC, that Dane, whoever. Don't
he looks like a white cop. That's like,
he looks like he looks like a black Mr. Peanut.
Fact, that person know nothing about history. He's like a pseudo historian. So
what the hell are you talking about?
Some Dane.
Here we
Dane,
go.
Somebody.
Here
we
Anytime
go.
Someone comes in, what the hell are you talking about?
My love room, honey, promoting someone who has no relevance when it comes to history or politics or whatever. So. Don't do that. And please hit the like button. And also,
is she talking to him or
he's,
her?
He's got something cocked and loaded.
Oh, he is ready to go.
Fucking roll.
He's jacking off right now.
But
slowly.
You know,
he's slowly tugging his giant pecker.
The cops, if you're outside playing your music loud,
I'd love to hang out.
Talking loud, confiscating.
That is classically what we're talking about, Dana. That's lack of manhood in the neighborhood. You don't share your music from two blocks away. The men go say, turn that shit down.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, get on your pull your pants of shit.
One of the reasons some of these old scoundrels are getting out of hand popping caps is because it used to be they wouldn't do that because the grown men would hunt them down.
Hunt them
down. Hunt them down.
He's got to hunt you down.
Yeah,
so,
and then they get the fool, and then the fools get to talking about, they shot down another. Oh, hell no. Act like you got some respect.
Exactly.
Quit acting like that anyway.
Man.
Crime going
God,
up
he
too.
Rules.
Who, what type of people did he put away on his show? Like, was it like just like small claims bullshit?
Yeah.
Or was he
yeah.
like, was he just being like,
I think it was
life!
Like civil court.
Yeah. Like, was Judge Joe Brown just announcing life?
Imagine Judge Joe Brown was a Supreme Court justice. He's like, we're going to hunt them down.
Somebody's like, I didn't pay my rent for 2 months. He's like, life!
I know.
Keep it going. This is great.
Somebody came to me. Do you see what he did to me? Did I said, look, man, don't come over here out and knock the shit out of you after you've been
here. Speaking of crime, I sent you, I text you this, the city of Newark, created, put this big statue of George Floyd on a bench in front of
City
Hall.
Oh, his face. He looks like somebody pepper sprayed him. He's so annoyed.
Here comes Uncle Ruckus.
Black. It's been majority black since the 60s. Had the first black mayor in the 60s, right? There was so many other people that you could have made a statue of. Whether it's Marcus Garvey, Frederick
She's
Douglass,
on some fucking Uncle Ruckus
Baraka,
shit too.
Because Oz Baraka, who was president, that was his father.
I'm cold-blooded. I don't give a fuck. Let's say this. Look, you know what's bad about George Floyd? George Floyd is 6 feet seven, 250 pounds, and he didn't get shot. Essentially, he got his ass whooped by a 5 foot, 8 inch tall, 135 pound white man. Killed him with no weapons.
And he was crying.
Yeah,
and he was crying.
And that's Jesus apparently a bad Christ. Thing in the view of Judge Joe
Put
Brown.
Yourself in a position of
dad crying
down.
Like
so
a
Judge
bitch.
Joe Brown is saying that he should have kicked that cop's ass. Yeah. It's just cool.
That yeah, is cool. And then they shoot him to death.
Right. And then,
it's like pick your poison.
Right. Like, he'd be like, listen, he threw hands at the police. You're not supposed to do that with the police. And of course you're going to get gunned down.
They should put him in a skirt in his statue. He should be crying like a bitch in the statue, wearing a little skirt like a sissy bitch.
And some red lipstick and some rouge.
Give him some lipstick. Call him Georgita Floyd, that little bitch. This is Judge Joe Brown. I'm signing off.
Because I'm cold-blooded.
Listen, I'm cold-blooded, youngin.
I don't give a fuck. God, that was good.
Feed on fentanyl, which is not a black drug anyway.
Those are white people. Dude, Judge Joe Brown rocks.
He out there doing all types of Mac Miller drugs and Kurt Cobain white nonsense drugs.
Oh, what a cool guy.
2% of each year's opiate-related deaths. And we got to make a statue of somebody who's 6 feet seven, 250, and got his ass whooped.
Who contribute nothing to the black community.
Tall, 135-pound white man.
Damn.
Contribute nothing.
That's embarrassing.
This is a fucking take I have not heard.
You've never thought this would ever be a take.
This is not like a black conservative take. This is like a weird.
It's just a crazy guy on a porch take.
This is like a fucking like God. What are those fucking Muhammad ones, the fucking
oh,
black five, Islamic.
5%ers or 2%ers or
black Israelites.
Black Israelites. Yeah. It's like a black Israelite take. This is cool.
Yeah, it's a very alpha take.
Dude, I got beef tips from a black Israelite. Shredded pork from black Israelite in Atlanta. He had this like fucking barbecue truck, and me and my buddy go there, and I was like, it's really fucking good pork. And then he started so I'm like sitting there and I was like, how do you like serve pork? Like, how do you eat it?
He goes,
like,
that ain't pork, that's George Floyd.
The little bitch.
We call that long pig.
We fried him up.
It was 250 pounds, 6 foot seven. That's a lot of meat. No, he's like, he fucking.
I killed him with fentanyl.
this dude's like sitting there and I'm like, how do you like eat, serve pork? And he's like, well, I bless it. It's okay now. And I was like, all right, like, I'm not going to get around your like rules. But then he was like, he spent like an hour. It was the most authentic experience I ever had because like the next like 20 minutes while I'm eating these like this like shredded pork and like with like toast, he's literally just telling me how Jesus was black and how I'm not an actual Caucasian and how I'm just like a mountain monkey.
Wow.
I was like, yeah, dude. Like,
you're just eating like, uh-huh.
I'm like, yeah, man, you're fucking right.
Jesus.
Oh, it's great. He called me a monkey. It was awesome.
Yeah, Judge Joe Brown's take here is almost like he's just upset that men can die.
Yeah,
he's like, don't respect any man that's died.
He doesn't like chicken shits, and according to Judge Joe Brown, the bar for doing chicken shit is very, very, very fucking high.
Should you sit up here and
I love this yes woman.
Yeah,
she's just
wild.
She's kind of cute.
No.
Honestly.
No.
Comment, Devin. Comment on this YouTube video.
Bad, but I mean,
advertise the podcast.
I mean, look at all of the other black folk have died, and you want to focus on him? Who put that out there?
So I said this.
He hasn't been watching the news at all.
Do create that statue or holidays, George Floyd Day or whatever. Do the Democrats get money?
Oh, he's like doing a cuckoo thing with his hands.
From the state or the federal government if they do that? Or from the Democrat Party?
The inmates have taken over the asylum.
Thank you, Ish, for the Cash App, and thank you, Christopher, for the Super Chat.
And because mainstream and social media, they're turning the outside into the inside of the asylum.
He's right. Interesting.
You're correct, Judge Joe Brown.
I would love to hear Judge Joe Brown's take on Cosby. I just bet it would be fantastic.
He goes, "Those bitches were sleeping."
Hello. They didn't have to drink with Cosby.
I stayed up every time I drank with Cosby. Tell me what's the difference.
Male virgins. And what do you think about...
Wait, rewind this.
The rise in male virgins. And what do you think about the rise in incel culture?
Oh, shit.
You guys know what
it's
incel,
a
right?
Sorry piece of bullshit. Grown boys. Black, white, brown, red, and yellow can't get any goddamn pussy. That is pathetic. And that's also a product of no men around to teach you how to approach women or what's going on.
Use the Spanish fly.
Disgusting. And incels are a bunch of goddamn punks want to go around and kill off women instead of protecting them because they're too damn lame to know how to get laid.
Hell yeah, dude.
There you go.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Pretty good.
Okay.
I'm now only following Judge Joe Brown. That is the only politics I'm following.
Well, my question is,
everybody's gonna be like, "Have you heard the new Rogan episode? Have you read the
Rogan as Judge Joe Brown?"
Oh my god,
Judge Joe Brown has enlightened me more than any Jordan Peterson.
This is better than Red Scare. This is better than Chapo's Trap House. I'm listening to Judge Joe Brown.
25 to 18, and there are females. There are more boys 30 years of age living with their parent or parents than there are girls. And it's a shame.
Yeah.
Your game is lame.
And you better blame. Al Sharpton thing.
You have this. In America, about 5.5657% are LGBTQ for the old population.
Oh, shit.
55 and over, it's about 1.5 to somewhat less than 2%, depending upon where you get your stats. For 18 to 25, 16% are there. So they go gay because they can't figure out how to get laid. Can't get a lay, so they go gay. That is a shame.
And if you are want to have sex, this is not the sexual revolution in the 70s, so make sure you strap up.
What? That's my next wife.
Please don't go in these women
but
raw
see,
because
I'm
they have a whole bunch of stuff
that,
going on.
A whole bunch of them won't pull out. They think they got to go pop because I'm going to do it. You're going to have my baby. Why? Because that shows I'm a man. No, it doesn't, fool. It's about how much you can pay in support or provide support, not how many you can have. That's just something straight off of a slave plantation. Massa, I done knocked up some more yo cows, sir. Can I show have some more cone pone?
What a finale.
Amazing. What a term. Wow. Cone pone. What is that? What did he say?
Corn porn.
Amazing.
I have no idea.
Oh, man. Judge Joe Brown's cool as hell.
Wow.
Wow, what a cool guy.
Now, that's the reckless talk that Chappelle has been dying for.
Talk
that's
reckless.
What I'm talking
about. Yeah.
Reckless talk.
Imagine if DaBaby said that.
That was crazy. What is his show like? Like, what does he do?
See, I don't know.
It's just, yeah.
He goes, "You look like you don't get no pussy. Life!" He's just handing out life.
Turn it on.
I'm trying to find Judge Joe Brown court.
Just look up funny.
Yeah, like
Judge Joe Brown
funny. Best, whatever.
Best, funny. Yeah, best.
Funny moments. Oh, here we go. Classic episode. Devin Clark. Put on Devin.
They're all like 10-minute clips, though.
Just turn it on.
Yeah, let's just see.
It's a commentary podcast.
Oh, it's almost got a million views.
There we go.
Into it. God damn. Everyone remember, TurboTax is there for you.
God, I'm going to get fucked by the IRS.
Why?
They can't touch me.
You don't make enough.
Yeah, I do. I get shit done.
Well, they're going to take all your dead dog money.
Oh, he's talking about Pratt. Have to get in shape really fast. Oh, no, never mind. It's some ad.
It's an ad.
Dude, they heard us talking about Chris Pratt, and they sent us an ad.
Doesn't have a cushion to survive a busted iPad. Traveling technician Michael Tillman is suing his friend for an iPad and laptop.
Defendant Devlin Clark says it was an accident. Now all right. It's Joe time. It's Joe time.
Suing Mr. Clark, it would seem that December 4th year last, the two of you were hanging out in the bathroom smoking cigarettes when you decided to step outside. Your iPad, which was on the sink countertop, was knocked off by the defendant.
Who's 6'7", 250 pounds.
Also broke your 15-inch MacBook Pro.
Yes, Your Honor.
Year proceeding still is not paid for that.
Pause it real quick.
You say,
Devin, if you broke an iPad I had, it's fine.
Right, I don't think.
But if you broke a laptop too, you gotta.
We gotta go to Judge Joe Brown.
Devan Costa, you said you wanted something to eat at 7-Eleven.
And you're telling me you were in the bathroom smoking cigarettes, sucking each other off.
John, you say you drive to 7-Eleven every time. And Devan wants somebody eat something every time we go.
Now, it says here that the computer was broken in the cum shack. Now, what part of the house is the cum shack?
So, Joseph LaFleur, you gave John a weed pen, and he proceeded to buy a Sasha Gray fleshlight, which he fucked for a fortnight.
Says here the desktop background on the MacBook Pro was Lemon Party. What is lemonparty.org?
Show that to me.
Show me lemon. Why is my homepage meatspin.com?
What is Penn Island?
What these two boys here on Meatspin are doing is 15% of the population.
Your defense, sir.
Dude on the right looks sick.
It was an accident.
Yes. Yeah.
And that the only reason you touched the iPad before it fell and was broken is because the plaintiff asked you to pick it up for him and you dropped it by accident.
What if that dude was like a black Mr. Bean?
Okay. You first. Mr. Tillman.
Yes, Your Honor. I like to explain how I know Devlin first. It's through my mother. I met him when I first moved to New York in 2003. We've been mutual friends, you know, of each other for a while.
Devlin looks like he's up to no good. Also,
that he introduced me to.
He looks a little shifty.
He shows up to my house on New Year's after me not seeing him for a few months. It's actually the day before New Year's. And I haven't seen him in a while, so we were a little excited. I'm like, you know, what's up? Where you been? How are things going? And he's like, okay, you know, he wanted to get drunk. And I'm like, okay, that sounds like something that I want to do too. You know, it's New Year's Day, so I'm like, let's do that then. Let's go get drunk. So we go to the liquor store and get three bottles of alcohol. And return back home. And
Judge Joe Brown's like writing notes. He's like, that's some foolishness.
That's some white boy stuff.
That's
right
some white boy
only
stuff.
White boys.
Y'all gonna do a butt chug? He goes, I've seen the jackass. Now, you two are a couple of certified jackasses.
They were drinking vodka. That is a white liquor.
You're drinking grain alcohol, butt chugging on New Year's Eve. Life! He keeps throwing out life sentences to anybody.
Drink. I had one drink and fell asleep before 12 o'clock. And I'm not even sure what he ended up doing that night. I do know when I woke up the next morning,
I have a theory.
Something I'll call my morning.
So Devlin, he goes to bed. He's fucked up. Devlin's still awake. He's like, I got fucking nothing to do. He's like, I'm going to beat my meat. He uses the iPad first, and then he realizes, oh, fuck, I don't have to delete the search history.
Yes, he just
sit on the ground. And then he's like, oh, fuck, okay, I can write that one off as an accident. I'm going to go in the living room. I got to beat my meat again. He goes standing on the iPad.
He tried jacking off twice, drunk, and his only recourse, and because he doesn't know how to delete the history, is he just keeps hammering the skies.
He's like, it was an accident.
Devlin does look like he's...
Devlin looks like a little horn dog.
He looks like such a horn dog, dude. He looks like he's stroking it behind the stand.
He's got a hole in his pocket right now.
A group of stuff that I need to do in the morning before I'm able to do anything else. And it's on my iPad, usually where I do it, or from the computer. And it's checking emails and different things of that nature. So I wake up and I grab my iPad and I go to the bathroom. Someone's in there. I knock on the door. He's in there. I'm asking him, are you using the restroom? He's like, no. I walk in. You know, we usually sit in the bathroom and smoke cigarettes. I'm a single parent of two kids, 2 and 6 year olds. So I don't smoke around them. I walked out of the bathroom. Well, walked to the bathroom and I'm like, oh, I said, oh, I forgot my cigarettes. So I laid my iPad on the sink and I went and got the cigarettes. It was literally 5 seconds. It was in the room right outside of the restroom. Come back in and I pick my iPod up, and I go to, you know, finish what I was doing. And something seemed a little odd. I didn't realize it at first. And then I'm like, I look over him like, you broke my iPad. And he's like, he's just sitting there looking stupid. And I'm like, say something. And he's like, I'm like, don't even sit and tell me that you didn't break it because I'm pretty, you know, what else could have happened to it? And then he can.
Are you guys getting
like,
a download okay, vibe
yeah,
from these dudes?
Okay, I did break it, but he.
A what?
Yeah,
download vibe. They were in the bathroom banging.
Yeah, no. Do you get a download vibe from this, Richie?
A little bit.
It was over. Like, he can't touch anything of mine. So, you know, I kept asking Mr. Clark. I was like, you're going to have to pay for this. I want my money for this. And he's like, all right, I'm going to get it. I'm like, yeah, but this is not going to work like with the MacBook. Like, you've been owing me that money for a year. I'm like, I want my money and I want it like.
Is this dude on Klonopin?
How are you going to get my money? He's like, I'm going to get it.
He's high, yeah.
And that. I'm like, no, it won't work. I was expecting him to go loan the money from somebody or something. That never happened. Mr. Clark still every
Judge
year
Joe Brown is just drawing penises.
He's just drawing him in a cage. He's like, life!
He's drawing a picture of him in a cage.
If you don't start making a better effort,
still stick figure with an afro.
And he left my house and didn't come back. I ended up like catching him 5 days later or whatever. Like,
at the end of the court case, he just goes.
He holds it up. He goes, Devlin, life.
Like I had two heads, and when he came to my house,
they're
he
fucking.
Saw that I wasn't lying; that I really had done it. And he's like, "Well, we've been friends for X amount of time. Why would you be suing me?" And I'm like, "Friends don't have anything to do with that $500 and some iPad, because I had to work to pay for that. You know, that was a that
Who
was a lot of money.
IPad?
That was a lot of hours I had to go to work for that. I don't like to go to work." I'm just saying, I do it because I need to make a living, you know, so I go to work, but it's not something I want to get up and go do, so I mean, if I could have a free iPad.
I want to hear Judge Joe Brown's take.
So, he seems to be unemployed since, and he doesn't go to work, but I mean, at least you seem to have the wherewithal character-wise to get up and go.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's go to the defendant.
Devin.
All right.
What's he going to say?
Okay. I went to pick it up because it was like kind of like at the edge. And when I went to pick it up, it slipped out my hand and hit the floor.
Why did you want to pick it up?
Why were your hands so slippery?
Yeah.
Were they covered in KY jelly?
They're covered in cum.
And it was time to grab them.
Well, that would have helped him grab it.
So I had to pick it up.
I have one here. Do you think I'm going to open this thing up to see what time we are facing right now, or am I going to look at my watch, you know?
Well, I don't have a watch, Your Honor.
But his phone was in his lap.
My phone was dead at the time.
Well, he needed to know the time to figure out how much time he was not missing by not being employed. And
very good, Judge Joe Brown. He's much better.
I'm like engaged.
Back
I love this show.
How did you manage to break that?
Well, my little cousin was playing. It was playing with his kids, and they was all playing around, and I was standing on top of the stairs, and they was playing around, and one. Where the kids was playing around, they hit me in the back of my leg, and then I was sitting at the top of the stairs. So
this guy's Mr. Bean.
I went to brace my fall when I felt like myself was about to fall down the stairs. So I grabbed onto the wall and I had the MacBook Pro in my hand. And when I went down and fell, I grabbed the wall and the MacBook slipped out my hands and down the stairs and went.
Have you ever thought of securing employment by simply writing up some of your personal episodes and submitting them as proposed sitcom episodes?
No, Your Honor.
All right. All right, I've had enough.
This is getting a little boring.
So, Judge Joe Brown is cool.
I want to see him come down on someone with that Judge Joe Brown take on life and how it should be.
Yeah. I wanted to see him get really like, that was just like silly. That was like him doing comedy.
But yeah, you want
to
see him yell it.
I want to see Alec Baldwin on Judge Joe Brown.
Yeah.
He's like, I didn't pull the trigger.
He goes, shut up with that foolishness.
Because I am not.
You white devil.
There are two primary victims in all of this, and I'm not one of them, and I didn't pull that trigger.
He's like,
no, he probably would have just been like, oh, it's like to the woman who died. He would have been like, you let another man point a gun at you? Mm-hmm. Who let somebody point a gun at them?
He goes, you're the director of photography and you let a bullet end your life.
You should have seen it coming.
Let's play a little bit of the Baldwin interview that he did where he's making content 3 weeks later about the murder he committed. Interesting. Interesting world we live in where this is somehow for the victims, but it's just to vindicate him of any
of something
guilt.
That happened a month ago.
This woman's dead.
Astroworld doc got taken down. That came out.
And he's
like,
doing
the day
this
after
is an
happened.
Hour special. He does. This is like LeBron's The Decision, but about like him killing somebody.
Tragic accident. Why speak out now?
Well, I think that there's a criminal investigation, and that could be a while.
And I've been told it's good for me to do an interview while there's a pending criminal investigation. Like, why would his lawyers let him do this? It's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
There's all kinds of civil litigation, and I felt there were a number of misconceptions, most of it from sources I really wouldn't concern myself about. But a couple that I did concern myself about, where there were these authoritative statements about, this is what happened. The sheriff's department hasn't even released a report to the DA yet. Mm-hmm. The reason I wanted to sit down with you is because I really feel like I can't wait for that process to end in February, March. I mean, I'm not asking them to speed it up for my benefit. That's ridiculous. But I am saying that they need to do what they need to do. And I wanted to come to talk to you to say that I would go to any lengths to undo what happened. I would go to any lengths to undo.
And then he just shoots George Stephanopoulos. I'd go to any lengths. He pulls out a little hooker gun from his boot. He goes, pow! The thing that's hilarious about this is that I saw a lot of clips from it. It's an hour long, so there's like hundreds of moments of them both showing each other how the gun went off, and they're making the gun finger.
Yes.
And it's like, why would you do this in this internet age where now there's all these memes of you and George Stephanopoulos pointing finger guns at each other like Gran Torino?
Has anyone made a meme about it?
No, but it's just stupid. It's just like, there's like a 10-minute part where he's like, no, it went cock, 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 and I went, do you want me to hold it here? Bang, bang, bang. Like, it's just
where he's explaining like how he's like, so what, like he's going like this, and like, they tell you you need to jerk it back.
Yeah, he's doing
there's
the
going to be no
back. It's
so
just,
it goes like bang, and when it goes bang,
he's just doing this cartoonish reenactment of this thing that happened 3 weeks ago.
What happened?
I think the big question, and the one you must have asked yourself 1,000 times, how could this have happened?
Well, there's two things I want to say about that. One is that when I talk about this, my concern is that I don't sound like I'm the victim, because there is a victim. There's a woman who died. And my friend got shot.
I can't remember
her
name.
He's my friend. And she was a new friend. I met her and we worked together on some of the mapping out of what we're going to do on the film, which, you know, in the movie terms, if you go make a movie with Scorsese, you and the DP don't sit down and they solicit your ideas of how to make the film. You know what I mean? In the case of Helena, we sat down collaboratively.
Why is he throwing Scorsese in?
What is that even? Yeah, he's like in Scorsese.
Yeah, he's nickname dropping.
He's like,
if Scorsese killed you, he wouldn't be doing this interview.
He's like, you know, in the case of Martin Scorsese, he's never killed a DP.
So he doesn't even know what this is like.
Doesn't even know what it's like.
Tarantino hasn't killed a DP.
What's up, John? What are you going to say?
Keep it going.
You're really
this is my day off. I'm just fucking recovering.
I want to make sure that I don't come across like I'm the victim, because we have two victims here. And the second thing is that all of what happened on that day, he's leading like, up to this
he
event,
goes, he's like, was precipitated. I'm not the, quite frankly, my hands are covered in blood in this situation.
When the front of my blouse was covered with her skull fragments, and I was standing behind that camera, and I had that gun pointed, and Joel Souza's crying to the sky, I thought to myself, where is that little piggy daughter of mine? Where the fuck is that little piggy daughter? Because I need to get the fuck out of here. I need to flee.
Anyway, that's the victim.
The victim is my piggy ass daughter. My fat piggy little piggy daughter. Because now I don't get paid to finish Rust. So she's not going to have a good Christmas.
Well,
so.
I didn't realize she was dead when she first got shot, because when she hollered out in pain, I thought it was my daughter squealing like a pig.
Now, since I'm not going to be able to complete the movie, my little piggy daughter can't have cake every day.
I would have given anything for the DP to be my daughter.
Elena was a new friend, not unlike my old daughter, who's a piggy and fat.
God, where's the other ball? Where's the Baldwin brothers in all this?
Oh, I don't know what they're
doing. They were the shooters on the grassy knoll. Chris Baldwin,
they're just CIA operatives.
He's got his shitty fake blonde hair. What do they look like now?
Billy Baldwin?
Billy Baldwin, yeah. Look, there's two of them, aren't there? There's the one that was in the. There's the one that was in a motherfucking.
Yeah, there's Billy. And then I want to get to these parts where
skip
they're
to like,
get
to where it's he closer cries. To like 15 minutes
get to
where they're both going bang, bang,
bang.
Yeah, that's later on. The local
crew with long
was to give more of the money, and I'm. You have no idea how unique an environment. Movie the
movies.
They keep showing scenes from a movie that nobody saw of his. Like him with fucking Sean Connery, and they're both holding guns in a cabin.
Yeah, no, it's the Anthony.
Anthony Hopkins.
Hopkins, yeah. I mean, it looks kind of cool, low key. I like Mountain Men movies.
Look at this. They have like drone shots of the desert. Alec Baldwin unscripted. Yeah.
This looks like Jason Bourne.
It's from the movie Rust. They just.
Yeah, this is the movie.
That's the unused footage.
We were at Bonanza Creek Ranch.
Day of their 21-day shoot.
David Halls is just hauling ass in the drone in his new Jeep Cherokee.
David Halls is the other guy that's being accused of misdoing.
Baldwin was preparing for his next scene. A shootout. Inside this wooden church.
They walked in on him beating the living hell out of his piggy daughter.
Set the scene right before that happened. You're sitting in a pew in the church.
Set the scene right as it happened, but do it as Donald Trump.
The two guys are there who have got me
I didn't pull the trigger.
And they think I'm shot pretty bad, and I'm kind of wilting, and they have a gun, and then a sound outside distracts them. And I would draw the gun out of my holster, pull the gun out like that.
There it is.
There it is. He's pointing the gun.
I'm handed a gun, and someone declares, they said, this is a cold gun.
Dave Halls.
Oh, the first AD. In my years on the sets of film, hot gun meant that there was a charge in there, and cold gun meant there was nothing in there. When he's saying this is a cold gun, what he's saying to everybody on the set is, you can relax. The gun is empty.
Chill. It's a cold gun.
It's a cold gun.
Well, cold gun means there's no charge in there. There could be dummy rounds.
A dummy round looks like
dummy
a
round.
Yeah, he literally did the whole like,
there could be dummy rounds.
He keeps doing the handgun thing. He loves it.
No explosive charge. And you were rehearsing that scene. Was it an actual rehearsal? There's some disagreement about that, whether it was a formal rehearsal at that time.
This is a marking rehearsal where I'm going to show her. She's standing next to
me. He just pulled another gun out.
Or me. She's got a monitor here. The camera is here filming that way. She takes a monitor that is his monitor, the operator, and turns it toward her. It swivels, and she
in
says, hold the gun lower.
I thought, what would it be like to take her life?
Okay, right there. Show it a little bit lower.
I thought of my tweet from years back.
The gun.
Why not play that out in reality?
What would it be
she's
like?
Guiding me through how she wants me to hold the gun for this angle.
She's and doing a JOI.
He keeps drawing guns.
This is like the fifth draw.
I told you, he does mock gun draws the entire interview.
Fired in that angle.
So if you're shooting directly...
Now George Stephanopoulos is holding a handgun. Now if you're shooting... He goes, now say Helena is right at the end of this gun, right? So say, imagine if you will, the DP, who's rest in peace, is behind
I thought about
my
her immaculate head, and I thought, what would it look like in pieces?
Someone
took this gun out.
Someone comes up and he goes, guys, stop pointing your fingers here. Use these. It's a cold gun.
It's a cold gun.
Here's a cold gun for you guys.
The gun where she told me to hold it. which ended up being aimed right in below her arm.
He just pulling goes, you won't get it this way. He just pulls out a real gun.
Incidental shot. An angle that may not have ended up in the film at all.
He goes, George, I'm a cowboy.
But we kept doing this.
George, I was a fucking cowboy.
I said, do you want to see that? And she said,
the
yes.
Fuck do you know about
so
it?
I take the gun and I
this is Hollywood, baby. You take on the role. You become the character.
George, I'm on the fucking range.
Can you see that?
George, it's the fucking open range, George.
I got my spurs. I got my six shooter.
George, I'm a fucking ranch hand.
Fucking cowboy.
He goes, George, it was fucking Bonanza Creek Ranch. You don't think shit gets wild at Bonanza Creek?
I'm about half a fifth of whiskey deep. I'm a fucking cowboy.
I'm a fucking cowboy. I'm down in Jack Daniels. I got the 310 to Yuma coming. I gotta get off this set quick. He goes, we gotta get out of Texas.
We gotta get out of Dodge.
We kept that when me and Devin were on that fucking road trip. I kept looking at Devin and go, we gotta get out of Texas. Just kept telling Devin, we gotta get out of Texas.
Gotta get out of Texas. We gotta make it to Laredo.
We're headed down to Patagonia, Arizona. We gotta make it out of Texas.
We gotta get to Laredo by sundown. Devin, they got a really good pecan pie, Blizzard, DQ. I gotta stop and have diarrhea for the fifth time today. We gotta get out of Texas.
Fuck it. He shot people.
What if he had a submachine gun? That would have been crazy.
So the first AD hands me the Uzi. He goes, cold Uzi.
So I'm on the set of Bad Boys 12, and someone hands me a Mac-10, and I'm sitting there, and they go, cold machine gun.
What if the CIA, they handed Stephen Paddock an AR-15? They were like, cold gun.
Oh, God. Lest we never forget his name, Stephen Paddock.
I mean, that's the most fishy fucking shooting ever. There's no info on it. No one. It's all hidden.
Look up the Wikipedia page. It's great. You just fucking. It's just like, yeah, it happened. No reason.
Right.
What are we on today?
This is
kind of we're just kind of.
This is an interesting one.
Around.
It's a calm Sunday.
It's a calm Sunday recording.
Cozy. We're gonna have some. It's a little chilly outside. You want to get some soup?
It is a little chilly.
We can get some soup.
Oh, dude, did you see what was happening to Seth Rogen's new show?
Oh yeah, Santa Inc. Here, Santa, you guys gotta let's
fuck off. He's making a Christmas show.
Okay, well here's the thing, Santa Inc. The official trailer, right? It had, they disabled the dislikes. It has 3,600 upvotes. It had 150,000 dislikes.
What is it?
And then his claim was
it's a movie. It's a trailer for the show.
I think it's a series.
A series where it's Santa is the first female Santa. And there's all these like black elves, and they're all like gay. And
Sarah Silverman's in it.
And
what has she been up to?
And Seth.
She has a podcast.
Oh.
Seth tweeted.
That there's like a bunch of white supremacists hate my new show.
Yeah, it's like you know you're doing something right when white supremacists hate your show. So this is it. We really pissed off tens of thousands of white supremacists with our new show Santa Inc., which is now available on HBO Max. Please read the responses to the tweet for confirmation. And the responses are just people being like, "You ever think
what'd
they?"
What did you say?
I didn't say anything.
Oh, never mind.
The responses are just like, hey, have you ever considered the audience rating isn't based on white supremacy and that maybe it's actually just not that good? And here's...
Very good commenter.
Very good. Listen to this, John.
When you're a kid, there's only one day a year more special than any other day. And that day is Christmas.
Isn't he Jewish?
Yeah.
We are.
That's why it's wacky. And so is Sarah Silverman.
Let's get these fucking kids some fucking presents.
Isn't that funny? Because it's like it's Christmas, but like the elves curse.
Yeah, they curse. Yeah.
They cuss, they swear, and I'm sure they smoke.
You know,
pot,
God forbid we try to make something nice.
Yeah.
You know?
No,
God
no.
We, try to
we
make
need to ruin
nice.
Christmas, too.
Let's make those
Santa is a misogynistic piece of shit, and we need to change that.
Dude, what do we have, Santa? But he's like listening to Wu-Tang Clan and the sled, dude. That shit's gonna be sick.
He's like smoking a big blunt, listening to Wu-Tang Clan.
Okay, so it opens Shimmy Shimmy Ya by ODB is playing. And Santa is high.
Dude,
does he have a blunt?
Just keep watching.
Our own Santa Claus.
Hey, so Santa's Merry Christmas. And he's played by Seth.
You're on my naughty list.
Sausage Party fucking blew.
Yeah, Sausage Party sucks.
Sausage Party was openly racist. Like, it was crazy. It was.
New than they do in vaccines or the Holocaust.
That's great. I mean, disheartening for America, but great for us.
Be like, from the creators of Gotti.
Who will succeed you with Santa Claus?
Subtext, Santa's old.
It's just me, or am I getting like South Park vibes in the way these mouths are moving?
Good question.
Yeah, sure.
I'll some serious thought. Bye.
There have been many Santa Clauses throughout history. Some were loved, others loathed. But the position of Santa has mostly been a white man's game.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Who gives a fuck?
So embarrassing. And they disabled the comments. They turned the comments off because they're getting doxxed.
It's like fucking, you know, it's like an old pagan fucking dude. Mm-hmm. It's like a deity. It's like being like, yes, Odin's always been a white man.
Right.
It's like, what?
I know. Isn't it just based on some like old fable? And isn't Santa like crazy in the real story? Fucking, he kills kids?
I don't know. That's the Krampus.
Oh, okay.
It's like an old pagan. It's like an old white. It's from like the ancient times. Like a white guy.
Yeah.
Santa has to be white. Otherwise, he would be killed the minute he comes down the chimney.
Puerto Rican Santa.
Like, imagine a Puerto Rican Santa. He'd just be shot.
Oh, fuck. Oh, my God.
Easy. Things have got to change.
My advice to you is, if I die, get rid of my porn.
Oh,
I want to be the next
Santa.
Oh
my God, dude.
If this is your dream, you have to at least
what a hunk of shit.
You gotta get intimate with that jolly bitch, bitch.
Yeah.
I know you're
Isn't it racist to also be like, we're gonna make a progressive show, but all the black reindeer talk like black stereotypes.
Right.
Listen, bitch, that ain't the shit, bitch. I'm Cardi B, bitch. Like,
is that Cardi B?
Bitch, no. Every time you say something.
Yes, bitch, because it's empowering to call you bitch, bitch.
What?
Boy,
what the fuck is going on?
Mailed this in.
Santa and the board are all male and all white.
What?
Play golf,
this
drink,
is unreal.
Say things like, don't ever marry your mistress.
Just so you know, the women of the North Pole make fun of one of your dicks.
You're like purple.
Have fun wondering whose it is. What I need to learn is how to bro out with these guys. You know, shoot the shit, do shots, shoot shots of shit.
She has ideas, but can she really be the face of Christmas?
It's Hillary Clinton. It's a thing where he's Trump and... Yeah.
Dude, the North Pole's a boys' club.
Oh, my God. Holy mother of God.
I'll be named successor, die trying.
Merry Christmas, and to all a kick-ass night.
How much did that cost to make? Look it up. Look up the Santa Inc.
Oh my
look
God,
up the budget.
That's fucking insane.
Look up the fucking budget. Look it up right now. It costs $72,000.
Yeah, because it's fucking made. It's just claymation bullshit.
What?
Yeah,
it's celebrity deathmatch.
This looks like celebrity.
That costs $72,000
to make. Why don't we make a claymation thing? That's it.
Because they all suck ass.
Oh, don't you start with that shit.
Wait, Santa Company, is that
different? Oh, that's Santa Company. Oh, no.
Yeah, that's something different.
Look up Santa Inc.
That's a campaign.
Wait, it's a TV series?
Yeah, it's a series.
Oh, God, so there's hours of this?
Mm-hmm.
It has a 1.1 out of 10 on IMDb.
Oh, my God. Even the cog machine couldn't save you?
Oh, my God, dude.
Oh, go down.
Everybody dies.
Go to Wikipedia.
Seth Rogen's like lame now.
Seth Rogen's always been kind of lame.
Yeah, but not this bad.
Not this bad.
Not
bad. Come on. Pineapple Express kicks fucking ass.
Who is he fucking that's making him do this?
It's Hollywood. It is. You get in the belly of the beast and that you just start becoming retarded.
Jesus fucking
Christ. I remember when I met him, he was saying stuff where I was kind of like, what? Yeah. He was like, he brought up like Black Eyed Peas and their song Let's Get Retarded, and he was like kind of like,
That's funny.
He was like, they say retarded like a lot.
I say retarded every 2 seconds.
But it was like he was coming at it from like, that's crazy, like that we had that. That's not okay. Like kind of like that angle. And I was like, yeah, I guess. I mean, who cares? Like
every night, like some sort of like,
aren't you the fucking super bad guy? Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
What was that piece of shit movie he made with Charlize Theron where he's the writer for the president?
Yeah, for Vice. Yeah. He like works for like Vice and yeah.
God, that was so bad. This is what he makes now.
Yep. Distasteful Santa Inc. trailer. Awesome. Oh, they're trying to act like anti-Semitic comments.
How's it anti-Semitic?
Let's see what the comments were.
It's made by just a Christmas movie made by fucking Jews. What are you talking about?
The comments are anti-Semitic. There's
some.
Well, I mean,
that's always going to happen.
Seth Rogen, yeah.
Yeah. And with what they've made, they are being, you know, kind of piece of shit Jews.
Oh, this is interesting.
Yeah, being bad Jews.
Would I make a Hanukkah movie? I'm going to be real with you. Like, if I made a Hanukkah movie, it'd be weird. Okay?
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It'd be weird.
It'd be a little weird.
Richie would look at me and be like, it's kind of suspect.
Why are you so obsessed with Hanukkah?
Yeah, why are you making
Hanukkah? Also, why are you making Hanukkah unpure?
No, you know what I mean? Like, nobody gives a shit about Hanukkah.
He said this.
John, you should make a Yom Kippur
movie.
Have
you been lighting your menorah?
I like lighting them. It's like the only thing I do.
It was really cute.
Seth said this at one point. He goes, I don't think all of my ideas are good. It's almost easier when people are critical of you because it helps with the quality control. And this person shares that and goes, what changed, Seth?
Yeah.
Like, so this, you really watch that and you think it's funny? Like, you actually think everyone saying it sucks is because they're white supremacists?
Yeah, this is a real head up your own
boy,
ass
dude.
Move.
Boy.
It just seems unfunny and annoying.
He's been on a roll now. I mean, Pat, like the last week, it was the dude whose car got broken into.
Mm-hmm.
Now Santa Inc. He's also
Whose car got broken into?
Some YouTuber's car got broken into, and he complained about it. And he was saying some things that were like baiting a little bit. Like, thank God the LAPD and this shithole city LA. And then Seth comes in like, that's just like living in a city. My car got broken into 15 times. And like one time a guy left a knife. It was like actually a pleasant surprise.
You know whose car doesn't get broken into? Fucking Chris Pratt, because he follows LAPD on Twitter.
Hell yeah.
You know they got that guy under lockdown. They're like, we got you. They probably have they probably got a couple detectives outside his fucking house 24/7 just making sure nothing like that happens
to
Pratt.
Chris Pratt goes, because every time he goes to his car, he praises God.
He praises God.
And he said, thank you for another day without my car getting broken into. And then it starts, he goes, thank you God for
also,
starting
he,
my car
he
again.
He drives a tank because he has a don't tread on me shirt.
He puts his AR-15 in the trunk because it's not a concealed carry state. And
yeah.
This guy goes in the comments, he goes, this movie is so authentic, they made laws against even questioning it. And then this guy goes, I took my children to the North Pole Museum to show them what people are capable of.
Oh, God.
Boy. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
I finally get to live every Jewish boy's dream of being fucking Santa Claus. Is that every... Did you ever care about Santa?
Did you care about Christmas? Yeah, tell me
I mean,
this.
Christmas is by far the better holiday. I always wanted to celebrate that instead. But
Christmas
other than that,
the better
I don't give a shit about being Santa Claus.
I'm going to be real with you, though. Christmas is the better holiday only because, like, by design. Like, when it started, it sucked ass.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And, like, it was probably worse than Hanukkah, to be honest. Because it was, like, one day you got, like, a sock full of stuff, like cookies.
Hanukkah's bullshit, by the way. It's not even like connected.
Wasn't it about the Roman invasion of
There's a story,
Israel?
But no, it's the Maccabees, and they were running out of oil, and they lasted for 7 days. I mean, that's like a fable, and they based that around a holiday just so Jews would have something around Christmas time. But it's not like Christmas is a real thing for Christians. Hanukkah's like not really that big a deal.
Really?
Yeah, it's just a way to compete. There is a real story based behind it.
Jews have a lot of like stories of resistance, though. Like Christmas isn't really like Christmas is just like I think it has to do
Passover
with, like,
is the one you're thinking.
Yeah.
Passover is more like our Christmas.
Which one was the one with the
but we don't get presents.
The famous, have you seen that famous, I think it's in the Vatican or something, they've tried to remove it a bunch of times. It's literally just like a carving, what do they call that? A carving in a wall. It's like
scripture?
Not a scripture, it's a, oh, I know what you're talking
hieroglyphics.
About. With the ichi bichi thing, the writing on the wall thing. No, it's the King David, the fucking, it's like a mural in a wall that's carved.
Oh, oh, fuck, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about, though. And, like, there's, like, a famous one of literally, like, a bunch of Roman soldiers, like,
a
just
crest.
Carrying. A crest. Yeah, something like that. But they're just carrying a giant... Is it called the candlestick holder? What's that called?
Menorah.
They're carrying, like, a giant menorah out of Israel. They've tried to remove it a bunch of times. Wasn't that what Passover was about?
No, Passover was about putting blood on the front of the door that was the so Egypt that God thing. Would pass over your house and knew you were a Jew when he was going through.
What was Hanukkah about the fucking Maccabees? Because they fought They fought the Romans, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So that was the thing.
That's what it was. No, there is a real story behind it. Menorahs.
Were they all white men?
look up. Mel Gibson screams about the Maccabees right now.
Okay, hold on. Listen, dude, look at this. I want to see what this tweet is. It goes, the movie theater when Santa Inc. start playing. Wrist like this, you don't check it for a game. Bunch of Jews in church or in temple.
Hasidic Jews.
Orthodox Jewish women are cute.
Dude, let's make a fucking movie where it's the Maccabees, but it's a woman trying to become a Maccabee, and they like won't let her.
Imagine showing
dude, the Maccabees are such Jewish a boys'
woman.
Club.
Imagine like showing an Orthodox Jewish woman like a Roku smart TV.
She'd be so impressed.
She'd be like, what?
Also, you can have your hair back. Let's go. Come on, sweetheart.
Yeah. Why? You should be like fucking infiltrating churches and just being like getting like wives.
At church?
Temples.
At temples? I mean, they really, you know, they're kind of ingrained in it. It's hard to pull them away.
I'll tell you right now, like my equivalent of that is like going to like Mormon churches. Because they're women.
You've been to Mormon churches?
No, I've just seen Mormon women. And
yeah,
they look
blonde
really,
and
yeah, because they're all like inbred and shit. So yeah, yeah, it's like a small gene pool.
You should go to Salt Lake City.
They look good. I don't know.
I mean, that's the spot. The spot.
Salt
for
Lake.
Mormons.
Yeah, I'll go to like one of those militant Mormon towns.
But I don't
just hang out.
But do they fuck, or is it one of those things you could?
Oh
probably,
yeah, they do.
Can you get them to do
they
like
gotta.
Anal?
They're
that's
really
like
crazy
the
to outsiders. The Mormons.
They gotta.
I feel like the move is you know the anal before marriage thing.
Shit.
That's their big thing.
That's cool though,
right?
Yeah, I think that's a move for a lot of people.
Yeah, anal before
I picked
marriage.
Up a dude from Saudi Arabia, and he said,
"He fucked
him
in the
that
ass
was the thing.
Before marriage."
Yeah,
picked up a dude from.
He's a dude from Saudi Arabia. When I was an Uber driver, and he was telling me like in Saudi Arabia, you have to. I was like, "What's it like dating out there?" And he's like, "Well, you can't meet in public." He's like, "So the two places you have dates are either while driving your car, which is." Sounds whatever, but he said like also you just get a hotel room and have the date inside the hotel room. And I was like, God, if you asked a woman to get a hotel room with you here, it'd be like,
yeah,
like
you're
slap
trying
in
to
the
fuck,
face.
Yeah.
But he was like, yeah, you just have like lunch in a hotel room, and then he's like, and then you have anal sex. And I was like, that's cool. Sounds chill.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Have a nice anal lunch sesh.
Yeah.
Eat some fucking.
Anal's only cool in porn.
Yeah, anal's not what it's chalked up to be.
Anal is cool if it's like if you really like keep it in the front of your head at how dirty it is. That's the only way anal's enjoyable.
It doesn't feel
as good as a vagina.
The only thing
all.
That's ever got me off about anal is that I'm just like it's not supposed to be there.
Yeah, exactly.
This
you got to be
crazy.
Gotta be like, this is filthy.
Right.
What I'm doing is
but that's
filthy.
It.
And
yeah,
she's
yeah, yeah.
filthy.
But
for
I don't think
it.
About
like,
the
yeah.
shit. That much. The shit I've aspect had, I'm putting yeah. out of my mind.
I've had poo-poo on my pee-pee.
Yeah.
Really?
Same. But
not like full-on like brown, but like you get that yellow grease.
Yeah.
That's
gross.
Yellow grease.
Yeah.
This is not a nice image for the
and on that,
for the listener.
On that note, folks, we'll wrap it up.
What do we got time-wise?
I don't know. Where are we at?
Like an hour six.
No, it's fucking.
I guess the only last thing I saw this week that sparked my attention, maybe we'll do a send off with. Did you see Elon Musk's new haircut?
Oh, yeah. He kind of looks like Richard Spencer now.
Yeah.
Oh, turn on the Maccabees.
Fuck Elon Musk. He was like talking. He was like saying fucking Bernie
Mel
Sanders.
Mel Gibson has
this
famous video where he's screaming about where his Maccabees script is because he was writing a script about the Maccabees.
Yeah, do that.
It's great.
What is it?
Look up Mel Gibson Maccabees. There you go.
Oh, there's more Mel Gibson like yelling?
Oh, yeah, there's more Mel Gibson.
Fuck you.
Yeah. Rocks. This is right after his divorce, though. So it was like a while ago.
Whatever, that's fine.
You were.
I wish Mel Gibson had made Santa Inc.
If Mel Gibson made Santa Inc,
it would be
an Oscar-winning movie.
Yeah, and it would be Santa just killing all the Jews.
Oh, that's right. He was in that sick movie. I heard that was good.
What?
How long before a judge orders Mel Gibson to take anger management classes?
Never.
The
fuck you.
The latest blow-up from the movie star and director has been released to the public.
Let's go, scumbag.
The world should be taking Mel Gibson management classes. Mel Gibson.
We should all be more like Mel.
Star in Costa Rica. Esterhaas and Gibson had been working on a film called The Maccabees, about a legendary Jewish army that took control of Judea before the time of Christ. Gibson, apparently angry about waiting on a script, laid into the screenwriter, whose 15-year-old son had his iPhone ready to record this little gem. Gibson also hollers about
he's the angriest dude when he rocks, gets angry.
He rocks.
I can't believe his head hasn't he's exploded. Like he oh my god.
He's the shit, dude. He is the coolest guy.
That is amazing.
Dude, I want to make I want to get a fucking you know when they have those actors round tables on YouTube? It'll be like fucking Mel Gibson, it'll be fucking Judge Joe Brown.
Yeah. That'd be amazing.
Chris Pratt.
Chris Pratt.
Chris Pratt. The boy it's called the boys table. Yeah. God, I wish Robert Evans was still alive. That'd be a good one.
And we just make Seth Rogen stand in front of it naked,
yeah.
Wet and naked,
and they judge
shivering.
His penis.
Yeah.
He goes.
That's Gibson ranting at screenwriter Joe Esterhaus last year in Mel's Costa Rica home, losing it over a failed project dubbed the
Project
Jewish Braveheart. Joe's terrified son was recording.
He's, I've never heard anyone this angry.
Off the back of it.
What the fuck have you been doing that rocks?
Bombed, branding him an anti-Semitic loon who called Jewish people oven dodgers.
Oh my god. Oven dodgers?
When Mel denied it, he published the tape. Mel apologized for the outburst, but it's not the first.
How dare you! I don't want to cause him damage. But I do want to prevent damage.
Mel says he won't sue. In the United States, Emma Dallimore, 10 News.
Man.
What a
Mel Gibson is the last guy on Earth. I would take a punch to the face by Mike Tyson before fucking Mel Gibson.
Mm-hmm.
God.
Man, he kicks ass.
God, he's cool.
He's so awesome.
He's just
anyone
the
who's
man.
Anyone capable of letting loose like that.
Just amazing.
Richie has an immense respect for people who lose control. Or
oh, I love it.
Lose yeah. control or people who, whether it's uncalculated or calculated loss of control.
I have an
crime
immense amount of
calculated loss of control. Right?
Crime is calculated.
Crime is a calculated loss of control. It's
not
like,
all
okay,
the time.
Yeah, not loss of control. Time. Crime is like a calculated. What's a better way to put it? Crime is like a calculated.
Like at some point you're making a decision.
Breaking of social boundaries.
Yeah.
So that yeah. An uncalculated anyone, breaking of social boundaries or a calculated breaking of social boundaries, which you respect.
But just a guy just losing his shit is really what I love the most.
Oh, it's
I just
great.
Especially a grown man.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Someone who's supposed to like have you know figured it out to some point where they can't they
who's
know
had
they
so
can't.
Much.
No, he's just he's
they
been
who's had
so
this
much.
Life
who's
that almost
top?
No one can ever have, and he's still that
I
angry.
Know.
That's crazy.
Still over the Maccabees.
Yeah,
he's got
to
win. He's got to fucking win. That's that guy's life. He has to be winning. Mm-hmm. If he's not winning, everything's wrong, and he has to scream.
Apocalypto is one of the most impressive movies I've ever seen.
It's
and,
a
no matter what he does for the rest of time, film. I will always show.
I just want to hear Mel Gibson scream about like every movie, just like where is my script of Ocean's 11?
Didn't he make?
I mean,
like,
Ocean's 13.
Didn't he make a movie called The Beaver with Jodie Foster? Like. 10
I
years ago.
I just remember
strange.
he made Get the Gringo, and that was like a great little movie.
Where is Get the Gringo?
All right.
You fucking oven dodging producing pieces of shit. You know how hard it is to make a movie in this business when all you gotta do, you keep working with oven dodgers?
He fucking called the cops sugar tits.
Sugar tits! Suck my ass,
look up,
sugar
look up,
tits!
Look up his mugshot. It's the best mugshot on Earth.
On Earth.
It's the best mugshot.
It's better than Sinatra.
Let me tell you a story. He made the cops let him go in the bathroom and wet his hair before he took the mugshot. He wanted to look good.
Wow, look at him. He's like,
that's it. That's the one.
Wow, he
click
looks
it.
Great.
He looks fantastic.
It's like
he
a headshot. Good.
Yeah.
He could get more. Like, hey, yeah.
God,
he's
amazing.
He's incredible.
Long live Mel.
Greatest great anti-Semite guy. To ever live.
Long live Mel! And fuck Seth Rogen! That oven dodger!
That's the thing. It's like, which way, Western man? Mel Gibson or Seth Rogen?
What?
It's like, which way? Which way are you going? Are you going?
Right.
Are you going Mel Gibson or Seth Rogen?
Yeah, Mel Gibson should be making Santa Inc. He fucking has the respect.
It would rock.
It'd be so much better.
Yeah.
It'd be a million times better.
Yeah, it would start out with like, I should be Santa and be like, you're a fucking woman, bitch. Shut up. You'll never be Santa's a big fat white man. You'll never
you
be let in.
All those
why
reindeer.
Is there? Why is there a black elf in here? Mm-hmm. Get that black elf
out
of here. Get those
car.
Oven jumpers out of here.
What makes you think you can fucking fly a sleigh? You can't even drive a car.
He goes, I don't need all these black reindeer, baby. They're fakers.
God.
All right, let's go get some fucking food.
Yeah,
or something.
Food. Right. Oh, we got to do the post thing where we talk about what we're doing next.
Oh, yeah. We're gonna
go.
Let's go watch Judge Joe Brown,
let's watch
honestly.
Judge Joe Brown and eat sushi.
Hell yeah. All right.
Bye.